everybody, and welcome to FMW Death Brawl. We are live here, baby, in the Tokyo Dome. It is going to be one for the ages. I am Lee Dark, and I am here accompanied by Jeff Beck, and he's excited to be back in Japan, aren't you, Jeff?
Who isn't excited to be back at home? But speaking of home, the FMW World Champion comes home tonight. But up first, just as she said for the United States Championship, we have Cameron Logan Lionhunter challenging Tyler Ferguson.
Man, Jeff, I am excited to be here. You know, I've been away a lot lately, and I'm hoping sometime soon we can get our schedules back on track, me and FMW, and I can be here for more shows there on Weekly Evolved. But right now, I'm just able to make it to the pay-per-views, and I am excited because, you know, just like you guys sitting at home, I don't really know what's going on here. Cameron Logan Lionhunter is on his way to the ring, though, and I know that for a fact.
Following this match, we're going to have the triple threat pro fighting rules match between Steve Murphy, Muerte, and Christopher Rich.
Ooh, that's something excited for, Jeff, because, I mean, Muerte and Christopher Rich, they have a long checkered past. And then you go ahead and add in Murphy? I mean, we're in for a show tonight. And that's only the first two matches.
That's only the first two matches. Let's not get into the rest just yet.
Cameron Logan Lionhunter looks excited to be here in good old Tokyo, Japan.
If my records are correct, this is Cameron's first time in Japan, is it not?
I think he's been here before. I mean, he's been in every promotion, HKW, New Era Wrestling, MIW. He's had to have been in Japan at some point. Look who it is. I hear it all trying to fall asleep. From reports, Curry. Jeff, you've been rolling with these guys from place to place, you know, helping them with travel and everything. EOP member Tyler Ferguson, the Fallen Angel, as you were just about to say, the FMW United States Champion for the moment.
It is easy to get around the town when you're rolling with Robinson. And the rest of the men backstage should know that after tonight.
I'm always excited to be here in Japan. It's one of my favorite places. This is Death Brawl number 2, Jeff. I don't know if anyone made that aware to you. Death Brawl number 2 that FMW has ever had in its history. The first ever Death Brawl champion was King Dominator.
And as I understand, he will be taking part in that match tonight.
Well, I'm definitely excited to see where that goes, but I guess we got to start here. And this is going to be one for the record books.
From Battle Creek, Michigan, weighing in at 180 pounds, Cameron Logan Leon Hunter. Introducing the champion.
The crowd definitely fans of Cameron Logan Lionhunter tonight.
220 pounds. He is the United States champion.
Well, I know you're probably a little biased. You have been traveling with these guys. But not everyone is a fan of Empire of Pain.
Not necessarily, no. There are the diehard contingents that cannot stand the Empire of Pain.
And I bet them people are just praying that Cameron Logan Lionhunter is walking away tonight with his first championship win in FMW, fighting the good fight every time the chips have been stacked against him. Will tonight be any different?
And this isn't his only match of the evening as well.
Oh, Tyler started off dirty, kick to the midsection, kick to the face, and now he's talking some shit in the face. Oh, Cameron, though. Oh, look at that, Cameron. He's got him in. Oh, submission hold, Jeff.
Single leg crab. Tyler's got to get himself over to the rope, find a way to break free. Power of the legs early on in the match, able to get himself free.
Oh, look at that. What a nice suplex there by Tyler Ferguson as he picks up Cameron Logan Lighthunter. Oh, another kick to the midsection. Oh!
Running powerbomb.
Tyler Ferguson was maybe trying to get him over that rope, but I just don't think he was able to get the butt of Cameron Logan Lighthunter up over that top rope.
Says, fuck it, how about a roll-up?
Tyler Ferguson is pulling out all the stops, Jeff.
He's been in the ring with Cameron before. He knows exactly what kind of a competitor he's up against. And he knows he's got to get it done fast.
Oh!
Top rope moonsault with the stomach of Tyler Ferguson seemingly landing right on the forehead of Cameron.
That is a move that could end a career.
Or shatter a rib.
Tyler Ferguson has started this off dirty and has not let up since. I mean, he's made sure that he's stayed on top. Oh, Cameron, though. Reversal as I was talking. Can Cameron get that opening he needs? Neck breaker.
Cameron won't be denied. Slaps on the sleeper.
The fallen angel to his feet. Oh!
Over the top rope, out of the ring, flat on his back.
Cameron is definitely ring, like, the veteran that is Cameron definitely showed there. I mean, he knew where he was at in the ring, seen the moment, took it, but oh.
Hip check from Ferguson changed the momentum. A big knee right in the face buys him the space he needed. But Cameron's right back on the offense.
Oh!
Referees to the count of seven now.
Tyler's head bounced off the steel steps.
Repeated elbows right into the heart of Ferguson. And these two got to get back in the ring.
Ooh, by the count of nine. Oh! What a match so far. I can't believe this is just match one.
This country has a way of supercharging both the competitors and the audience.
Oh!
Senton over the ropes from the apron. Only good for a two count, though.
Sorry for knocking over your drink there, Jay. I'm on the edge of my seat right now, and I am just trying to see as much of this action as I can. Tyler Ferguson is trying. He's pulling everything out.
Cameron's the type of competitor. You have to give it everything. There is no lazy win over this guy.
Oh! Cameron
and for
Cutter.
Reasons like that.
Cameron Cutter!
But at the last second, the champion was able to get his shoulder up.
I can't believe it, Jeff. I can't believe it. I am starstruck right now. I thought that was it.
If you ever doubted Tyler Ferguson, you've got a reason not to right now.
Tyler able to escape the submission hold. He's trying to get back that opening he started this match with. Oh! Oh! That was smart thinking there by Cameron Logan Lionhunter with that reversal. Cameron pulls him over. Oh! Does the ref see? Ref did not see.
Doesn't matter if he saw it.
Kick out though. Oh! Cameron waited for
Axe
Tyler to turn
right
around.
To Ferguson.
What? These two do not like it. There is no love lost here.
Ferguson looking to get it going. Swept the leg. He's got Cameron exactly where he wants him.
Oh no.
Grabs the arms. There's the DDT.
One, two.
From the throes of defeat, Tyler Ferguson rises to the occasion and retains his FMW United States Championship here tonight.
What a match we just witnessed, Jeff. This is only the start of the show.
This is only bound to get more violent as the night progresses. As I said, we've got the pro fighting title match. Later on in the evening, we've got a Tokyo street fight. And following that, we have the namesake of the evening, the 8-man death brawl.
I am excited to see everything that's going down here in FMW. Death brawl. Man, the sound guy, he threw that at us kind of different today. I kind of like that. That was dope. Anyway, making the way to the ring, Steve Murphy.
Murphy's got to be a little frustrated tonight. You wanted, above all else, to come into this match with it being just a one-on-one. But now he has to make the rare triple threat pro fighting title defense.
I don't think it's ever been done.
You can blame Chris Rich. He didn't give management any other choice. They tried to book a regular one-on-one FMW pro fighting title match. What does Chris Rich do? He gets in the cage. And he screws that man right there, Muerte, out of an opportunity to win that belt.
Muerte. This man gives me goosebumps, Jeff.
He's quite the intense individual. Impossible to try to get a word with him backstage. I've tried. He just looks at you. No words.
Man. There's just something about this man. I have no idea what he looks like under that mask. If it is a mask, it's a mask, right?
I'm led to believe it's a mask. I would like to hope it's a mask. It would be a lot worse if that was actually that guy's face. This match would definitely be the sequel to Halloween Lockdown, if that was really that man's face.
Well, you know, the annual Death Brawl, which is now going to be annual. There will be another Death Brawl in Tokyo, Japan, in the Dome, next year. It's been made official by But I think it was made official by you, wasn't it, Jeff?
I was able to announce that just a few days ago, yes. This has to be the angriest man in all of FMW.
I mean,
denied the opportunity to regain United States Championship. He's made it his mission to become the pro fighting champion at all costs.
Christopher Rich. And I've seen his promos lately. The man has been psychotic.
He is obsessed.
Yes. Yes, there you go. That's the word. My question is here tonight, who is getting knocked out? Who's
with
getting
as pissed off as he's got the other two men, I think it might just be Rich tonight. I think they might just take him out of the equation first and then fight amongst themselves.
You know, if that
that's
is
what I'd
not
do.
What happens, I am going to be absolutely shocked.
You'd think it would just be Huerte that would be pissed off, but Rich is going at Murphy too.
Well, Murphy wanted it to be a one-on-one. Murphy didn't want no. Oh no. Oh man.
Right off the jump.
Look at Huerte.
Falling to the crowd, getting
oh!
going.
Oh! Backbreaker by Murphy. And Rich is back to his feet. Huerte now is getting double teamed. Murphy's in the corner. Oh, drop kick by Rich.
Rich said, I didn't forget what you just did to me.
Oh, back of the head punch by Murphy. That is some Murphy stuff right there. Murphy don't care if you're looking at him, looking away from him. If you guys are in a fight, he's punching you.
Anywhere.
Oh! Oh, Rich is caught on the rope. Gave Murphy the moment.
Dropped him right on his forehead.
With a double reverse DDT. That was a nice move there.
Off the top rope, swings him around into an arm drag. Rich right on to Huerte, takes a shot to the crowd before getting clotheslined by Murphy.
This is such a hard match to call. It seems like once a guy gets on momentum, he gets took straight out. Like, look at that. Murphy's down now with a twisting backbreaker.
He's on his back now, courtesy of Murphy, who hits a Scottish sickle right on Rich. Takes him right out.
These people here in Japan not happy right now. I mean, they are booing loud.
Who could you really favor out of this? If you're one of the fans in the audience.
They're starting to cheer now as Murte's getting going, but Rich to his feet. Oh, Rich dodged that. Rich dodged that.
Huerte unable to hit the enziguri. And Rich capitalized.
Just barely ducked under it. It was such a smart move there.
Couldn't duck that spinning heel kick, though.
Oh, Murphy to the... Oh! I think he was originally going for Huerte.
Saw Rich running and decided to hit him anyway. Just as Rich gets it going.
Oh!
Murphy spreading the love all around.
Murphy is looking good here tonight.
Kick to the face, but he was able to dodge that crossbody from Rich.
Oh, backbreaker. Oh.
Beautiful pump handle backbreaker.
Rich has Murphy in a headlock. No, broken by Murphy. Murphy clothesline.
Scottish sickle to Muerte. Murphy, he's just picking his shots right now.
I mean, the match has been so back and forth from everyone. It is hard to call. He was looking for a blackout, but Rich seen it, capitalized.
Not hitting that. I know what you do next. I don't know how much the other guy's got left in him.
Rich is taking advantage of the field right now. Everyone is hurt and downed. And look at that million-dollar driver.
Snapmare. Point of the elbow right to the top of Muerte's head.
Double reverse DDT by Murphy again. Stomp.
Looking to get a little bit of that momentum back. Rich turns it around on him.
Jeff, I gotta say, I'm gonna have to. I know everyone's mad at him. Everyone's mad. You even seem a little mad at him. But I'm gonna have to say, Rich.
Well, there's only so many bits of leeway that I can give you.
Rich is just. I mean, he's dodging everything. He's getting hit here and there, but he's not getting the brute. The brute of it is Murte and Murphy. Oh, and as I say that from behind. Oh, he got out of it. Oh. I think he's bleeding.
Starting to see blood on the face of Rich. Beautiful. Standing Shiranui. Right into a camel clutch, and Murphy's
just throwing punches right over the top of the head of Murte. He couldn't. Is his vision?
He couldn't break it.
Or he didn't want to.
He couldn't make Murte break that camel clutch.
Oh!
And for his efforts, he is rewarded with a $1 million driver. And just as you called it, Lee Dark, Christopher Rich is your new FMW Pro Fighting Champion.
Blood pouring down the face of these competitors. These matches are just, they're different, all right? Because we normally go to pinfall, you know, you can submit. This one is just, most of the time the person wins by completely taking out their opponent. It's a dark match, but man, what a battle.
Muerte still not able to get to his feet. The cage has been raised. Murphy out of the ring. And Rich pulling a $100 bill out of his pocket.
What
calls to the crowd.
Disrespect from Christopher Rich, the man that is also chasing his first ever title in FMW, gets rewarded with a $100 bill. From Christopher Rich.
The following contest is an
right
extreme
between the
match.
Teeth.
And it's for the Extreme Championship.
And just as the ring announcer says, Chris Michaels makes his way to the ring to challenge for the FMW Extreme title.
This is a man that has been a wrecking machine since his debut. Oh no! Oh no!
As is telltale of Hangman Johnny Gage, he's not gonna give Michaels the opportunity to stand and get ready. He's gonna hit him as soon as he can.
Michaels lucky he got turned around to see Gage. And Michaels is on a roll. The monster within him is being unleashed. And this savage is absolutely annihilating. Hey, man, I haven't seen anyone handle Johnny Gage like that in the start of a match. Oh, no. The monster's up. Head is cracked, and he's out of the ring.
Prevents Michaels from getting a weapon from underneath the ring there. And these two wasting no time to take it right back outside the ring.
What'd you call this match? What's the rules?
Extreme rules match.
Extreme
rules.
As
straightforward as it gets.
Later tonight, we have a different kind of match, right? A Tokyo street fight?
Yes.
Can't wait for that. Oh, Johnny Gage throwing Chris Michaels into the corner. He bounces off. And the monster is going to town.
Working at the shins and the knees of Chris Michaels. Snapping the neck.
Oh, and he ripped the bandana off his face and the t-shirt, threw it over the side. Oh, but Michaels.
Gage not endearing himself to the crowd and seemingly paying for it. What the hell?
Oh, he went for the punch.
Michaels went to hit Gage with a chair and it just bounced right off of Gage.
That monster. I've not seen people like him and his brother. Just two different behemoths all in themselves.
Like hitting a chair with a ball of iron.
There he goes. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you want that chair. Oh, he accidentally hit the ref.
Jesus Christ.
Jeff, where did that paper go? God damn it. Oh, it's right here. If you guys want that chair right there that just collided with the skull of Hangman Johnny Gage, make sure you start bidding on it. What? When is it going up, Jeff? About halfway on the show?
Tomorrow night.
Oh, tomorrow night. Sorry, it's tomorrow night. And you guys can purchase that chair right there, and it'll be signed as well, I believe.
Just got to make sure that the referee suffered a concussion there. That makes it worth more.
Oh!
Floors Johnny Gage
with
the heel kick.
By Chris Michaels as he tore apart that table, threw that top part onto Gage, and now Gage going after Michaels as Michaels is giving it everything he got. Michaels came into this prepared. 100%.
But how do you prepare for a man like Johnny Gage?
I mean, you were probably there, Jeff. I mean, you don't got to sugarcoat it. All the EOP boys are probably sitting around giving Michaels all the pointers, working him fucking like a dog.
There's nothing you can do, man. There's no Rocky Balboa montage that's going to get you ready for that kind of Ivan Drago.
Oh, are they going to sell that chair too?
Michaels might be contemplating it right there. He's contemplating something.
Oh! Gage acted like that chair meant nothing to him as he's already back in control. Bounced the head of Michaels off the ring apron there.
I wouldn't even call this a wrestling match. At this point, this is a fight.
Oh, yeah.
Drop kick right to the knee.
And Tokyo is absolutely blowing the roof off this dome.
Michaels has the steel steps. Gage gets out of the way just in time. I'm gonna stand up. I don't know where that steel step's going. All right, you know.
Who's this other guy?
It's down. I don't know. Brad said he wanted him here.
He thinks he's said a word.
It's because I had production mute his microphone. I'm not having him ruin the show.
Okay. All right. Anyway. Oh, hey, watch out. Watch out.
Front flip Hurricane Rana from Michaels. How many times have you seen him do that before?
Michaels, I'm telling you, EOP, they aren't just a faction. These guys make sure that someone goes into something prepared. I mean, you can see how good looking Chris Michaels is right now.
Thank you. Please, don't destroy my table. You got a whole ring to destroy each other in.
Oh! Johnny.
Those steel steps are getting used in more than one way tonight.
Yeah.
Michaels has another chair. It makes three.
The gauge. He's like an eight.
Back to basics.
He gets a hold of you, and there's nothing you can do about it. Just the strength of a vice.
Back across the apron, blood pouring from the face of Chris Michaels now.
Oh!
This is what I'm saying. There's nothing you can do to prepare for Johnny Gage. There's no surefire way to beat him. You just have to hit him harder, longer. And I mean a lot longer.
You know, I'm almost starting to get worried for the health of these two guys. They're not going to stop till one of them stops.
And you mean really stops?
Yeah. I don't know exactly.
Again, going for the steps.
If we can say the other word, so I'm gonna just stick to stops.
That works.
Oh, into the ring post. Oh, you hear that? My God.
That was a dull, unfortunate thud.
Oh, that made my Johnny stomach
Gage.
Hurt.
Michaels onto the middle rope, but Gage rolls just out of the way. Michaels aware of it. Stomp to the gut. Kick to the back, but Gage able to get out of the way. Michaels frees himself. Thrown into the corner and splashed for his trouble.
He throws up that execution X, and this could be the end. Oh!
Michaels got out of the way just in time.
He's trying. He's trying so hard.
He might be almost there again.
Ooh.
Going for the soup for the exploder suplex. Caught Gage up in the corner.
Oh, there it is! Yeah,
Birds
baby!
DDT.
That DDT is put away. I don't know how many individuals. And Chris Michaels is very happy with himself right now.
He should have gone for the pin.
No. No, no, no. 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 Wait. What the? That right there, Jeff, that right there is why I don't like these Execution Brothers. They are the most scary two guys I've ever met.
How do you prepare for that, Lee?
You don't.
There's no book.
You don't. In all my years of commentating, I've never witnessed stuff like this.
Just when you think you're about to hit the guy with your kill shot, he's standing behind you. Going for the legs now.
Chris Michaels looks pissed.
Knows he had him.
In another!
Going for the second purge.
Oh, ho, ho, ho. Chris Michaels yelling.
Arguing with the ref.
Yeah, which he don't speak English, Michaels. Oh!
Michaels doesn't care. He still told him to fuck off.
That was still a nice touch by, I think you, again, by getting a Japan referee in here. That was amazing. Oh!
It was easy.
And this could be it. Will this count, though? Will this? He's submitting! Oh, it's Extreme Rules. That didn't mean anything.
Does not count.
Oh! Chris Michaels rolled back into the ring. Gage. Oh! Michaels trying to get a break. Rolls to the outside. Smart man.
Needed the separation.
Oh, but he caught there by Gage. And like I said, ape-like grip, man. Grabs you, and there's nowhere you're going. He said, you want me to take out my legs? I'm going to take out yours.
Pulled a wrench on all of the ligaments of the knees.
Get Michaels to his feet. Oh, Michaels seen it coming.
Jawbreaker into his combination.
Michaels going for that cover. One, two, no. I don't know. I don't think there's any way to put out this guy.
But they said he found a way.
Oh!
That might be it. Purge DDT onto the chair.
Yeah! Oh my God! Someone pinned the monster that is Gage!
So three Purge DDTs and the third one was on a chair.
That man has held the Extreme title for 4 months? 3 months?
He took it from... Can he take it from Chris Michaels? Michaels got the win back. Oh.
He took it from Crunkman. Either way.
The United States title that Michaels held.
Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to Chris Michaels. He slayed the beast, and he is your new FMW Extreme Champion.
This makes the third belt that Michaels has held then since joining FMW earlier this summer. And as you hear the familiar tune, you know you are on to the tag team match of the evening. The Alphas challenging the Radicals for the tag team titles. In the last few weeks, the Alphas have seemingly had the number of the Radicals, defeating them in individual matches, in tag team matches, which has led to tonight. Can they do it when it matters?
The Alphas are a team that I didn't think was going to work. I ain't going to lie right now. I did not think that this duo was going to work out. But, I'm going to go ahead and say right now I was wrong.
It works when the belt isn't on the line. Does it work when the belt is? But that's what defines a tag team.
This team right here, the Radicals, have held the FMW tag team titles before. This is their second tag team title run in FMW. Will they be able to keep this going?
A lot of naysayers will mention, and they'll be quick to mention this, that Radicals only obtained those tag titles because Execution had a giant difference of opinion. But you gotta believe in them.
You know,
I think you could say anything you want to say. I think you could bring up that.
I think you could bring up the fact that the radicals themselves have had issues. But somehow, these guys always pull it off when the time is right. And they've proven it at least twice now. JMR as Billy Ray Dog flip. Oh.
Stomp to the gut. Follows up with a forearm and a stomp to the chest. JMR going quick to work on Billy Ray Dog in Billy Ray Dog's own corner. Beautiful lift into a cutter. Tagged to Daniel Dino, and both of them went for the drop kick. Neither of them able to hit each other. But JMR was able to hit the backdrop on Daniel Dino. And Christian's cheering on his tag team partner as JMR continues to work on Daniel Dino.
I cannot believe JMR suplexed Daniel Dino as easily as he just did. Oh!
I've seen the kid hitting the weights in the gym. He knows he's got a big fella ahead of him, and he's got to put on a little more weight to be able to lift him.
And the Maverick pulling all the stops.
Slips right between the ropes. Clothesline up against the apron. Dino picks him up. Big elbow right into the side of the head. Just as Dino gets going, JMR slips away and throws Dino into the corner. Right into the ring post. Referee's gotten to the count of six. JMR heads to the outside as Christian pulled up Daniel Dino. And Dino's been slammed once again to the outside. The count has been broken. Dino's bounced off the apron, and JMR makes his way into the ring. Christian slams Dino face first to the floor. And the ref continues to count, hits seven.
Absolutely incredible tag team work here by the Radicals, keeping JMR making it look like he's trying to get Daniel Dino back in the ring. Oh, but Dino's seen through it.
He was just bouncing him off. We had a completely different view from the hard cam that you're viewing from at home.
He's just bouncing him off the heel of Christian Gunn.
Dino has to remind himself that there is a giant separation between him and his tag team partner. And there's hardly any for him, or for Christian Gunn and JMR.
But Dino's a big boy. And he can, when he gets a rolling.
That he is, but JMR and Christian are a great tag team. Two will always outnumber one.
Billy Ray Dog now keeping JMR on their side.
JMR trying with all his might to get away. Crawl towards Christian, maybe get a tag in. Billy Ray Dog slams the knee of JMR right into the mat, going for the pickup. Went to wrench the arm, JMR punched his way out.
The tag. Christian Gunn made his way into the ring. Christian Gunn going for the cover. Daniel Dino knocked down. This could be it right here. One, two. Oh.
JMR celebrating a little early. Ref did not count the win.
And now Christian Gunn has Billy Ray Dog in their corner. Back to their side. Oh, spear!
But Billy's got no partner to tag to. And a right from JMR knocks Billy Ray Dog silly for a moment.
The Radicals have been one step ahead throughout this match. Oh! Point blank was just connected.
Billy Ray Dog into the corner of JMR and Christian Gunn. And it looks like we are going to have a little bit of a stampede here, Lee.
One hell of a stomp party.
Help, you know, from the tag partner.
Where I come from.
Basement dropkick.
Can't have a stomp party without a curb.
Spear to Daniel Dino. JMR is going for the pin here.
One, two. Oh.
The resolve it takes to kick out after getting stomped near to death by two men. Billy Ray Dog wants these titles bad.
JMR going to the top. Are we going to see it? No, just an elbow drop, but it missed.
Billy Ray Dog able to get up just in time, but was unable to get out of the half and half suplex.
JMR looked like maybe he was going to go take out Dino again, but decided against it. And now has Billy Ray Dog in a form of a figure four?
We're going to call it a crooked figure four, Lee.
Okay.
Right hands to Billy Ray Dog gets him out of that perilous situation.
Billy should have took that time to tag. But determined.
I was thinking the same thing.
Billy Ray Dog with a spin out.
Hits him with one of his best shots, looking to tag in Daniel Dino now.
Oh,
JMR gets out of the way. And Billy Ray Dog said not so fast, but a kick to the face.
Oh,
oh my lord, these two know each other so well.
Unbelievable series right there. But can Billy Ray Dog finally get that tag that he needs so bad? And he does. Daniel Dino's the legal man. Oh no! Oh no!
Throwing the big man right into JMR into a crossbody.
Just flattened the Maverick. We call that roadkill where I'm from.
And despite a submission attempt, JMR able to break free.
And two knees to the back. He knocks Billy Ray Dog down, but not the way he wanted to. Billy Ray Dog back to his feet. He gets the elbow to the face. JMR knocked a little silly now.
He's got to shake the cobwebs out and find his way out of the maze so he can get himself into a pin here. Still trying to get at Billy Ray Dog, but Billy Ray Dog able to get out of the way just in time. Not that time, though.
Oh. Oh. Oh, no. Oh, God. The strength of Daniel Dino.
Into a senton. Quick to go for the pin.
Christian
able to break the pin for his tag partner.
Right, and look at them stare each other down. Is Christian Gunn saying something?
Dino was telling Christian, wait until you tag in.
JMR doesn't even know where he's at.
He's trying to weasel his way around, find somebody to tag, some sort of help.
JMR goes straight for the back of Daniel Dino, but Daniel Dino too big. And Daniel knocked down, though. JMR
rolls out of the ring and back in. Catches him with a neck breaker.
And JMR taking the moment to taunt.
He's feeling himself.
That feeling himself has bit him in the butt a lot.
I know, with a DDT. Needs to go for the tag to his partner.
Billy Ray Dog still does not look ready to come in, but looks like they're going to pay back with a little stampede party of their own.
Eye for an eye here in Tokyo tonight.
Billy Ray Dog can't even see.
He can still fight. That's all that matters. JMR was able to catch Billy there.
Daniel Dino, like, fell down on the outside.
Still caught just enough time to be able to deliver a right hand to JMR. Big swing and neck breaker. And an enziguri off the apron right to JMR, who for the third time tonight has been knocked right out on his feet.
Oh!
Big spear to Daniel Dino that time.
Oh, knees to the back. One, two. Ladies and gentlemen, and still your FMW Tag Team Champions, the Radicals.
That was one hell of a match.
Man, is the show over yet? That was main event worthy.
We still have three matches to go. Chris Chaos versus Butcher, Mike Storm versus Joseph Robinson, and the namesake of the evening, the 8-man death brawl.
Sounds like shit's about to go down.
It sounds like the former FMW Pro Fighting Champion is about to make his way to the ring. There he is, Chris Chaos is here in Tokyo and ready to fight the other monster half of Execution.
You can always tell when Tokyo knows the person that just came out. That eruption that they just gave, and then complete silence afterwards. That right there is a traditional. That was amazing. You know what I'm talking about, Jeff.
They let the people know exactly who they love.
They go again, erupting, and then, bam.
Chris Chaos is loved all the world over.
Well,
Does he have what it takes to take the global championship off of that man right there? And conspicuously without the global championship, Butcher makes his way to the ring. Last few months, Butcher has reigned without any clear match here in FMW.
You know, I was talking about the two monsters of execution earlier. Butcher, definitely that other monster, in case you need that put in there.
We can finally hear you, Lee. Technical difficulties. Thank you, Brad. Can you get the hell out of the production? Despite not showing up with the belt, the referee has the global championship handy. And the match has begun. Quick kick to the gut of Butcher, and Chaos quick to start the match off with a heavy barrage.
In Butcher's debut, he absolutely leveled Triple C. And since then, he has been on an unstoppable roll.
He has been on an absolute warpath. But Chris Chaos seems like the right man to be able to take him down. Going for a backbreaker. Chaos was able to get the knee right up into the face of Butcher to stop that from happening and retake control of the match. Suplexes Butcher like he weighs nothing from the apron. Big kick to the back. Heavy Irish whip right into the corner.
What an unstoppable beast.
The Chaos isn't giving up any ground.
You know, the motivation right now for Chris Chaos, besides walking out of here as global champion, has to be that he's seen Chris Michaels put away Hangman Johnny Gage. Hell, everyone in the back should be excited now. Chris Michaels proved tonight that one, at least, of these two brothers, the monsters that are Execution, are beatable.
Chaos not wanting to take a count-out win because he will not win the title. Went right back to the outside and almost paid for it. But a quick clothesline takes Butcher off his feet, and it's not often that you see the big man on his back for that long.
Oh!
Just as he came outside the ring, he was caught with a neck breaker, courtesy of Butcher. But in the moments where Chaos has momentum on his side, it seems like Butcher is almost human. Off of the ropes, big back elbow from Butcher. Butcher going for the pinfall now.
Ooh, kick out.
Right before the count of one.
You know, I'm really excited for this match because Chris Chaos is a legend. Butcher is a beast. These two are going to absolutely tear each other apart here in the Dome.
I think a big motivating factor for Chaos isn't just the title. It's the fact that if he is successful, he also walks away with the pride of being the only man to be able to slay the beast that is Butcher. I've gone into detail and I can't see Butcher having suffered a loss since he's come to FMW.
You know, if he did, but well, the tag team titles.
You count that as a real loss, though?
I mean, it's a loss, but it's his singles career.
Flawless.
Flawless.
About as flawless as the escape that Chaos used to get out of that triangle choke. Chaos looking to set the big man up now.
Oh my!
Huge military press.
And that purge DDT going for the cover.
Not enough to put Butcher down. You've got to do more than every other man before you.
Chris Chaos was a man that literally bled HKW. So to have him here in FMW after they closed down was a complete honor. And he is just trying to be the man at the top to lead the rest of these youngins in the right direction. Oh my!
After a huge Chaos edge, Chris Chaos is the first man to slay the beast and is now your FMW Global Champion.
A Chaos edge. Wow. What a match.
Well, New York has what I want to say trademark, so. Standing tall tonight in Tokyo, your new FMW Global Champion.
And I can't think of a man that has fought harder than this man right here. Global title is going to be held high tonight as Chris Chaos has slayed the monster that is Butcher. It is now your FMW Global Heavyweight Wrestling Champion. And now, it is time for one of my favorite matches. Yeah, the World Heavyweight title match.
We all know that familiar music of Mike Storms.
Is he here? When you're born in the dirt, the only way to grow is up, so you
reach for the sun, but it seems every room that you... He's gotta be here.
I mean, I know sometimes he doesn't show up. There he is! Mike Storm actually showed up! He is here! In the Tokyo Dome!
And Robinson earlier today was quick to point out the fact that Mike Storm has had multiple chances to win the world title, but was unable to win them.
Maybe if he'd have showed up more, but he didn't. And so here he is, Mike Storm, coming down to maybe claim the world heavyweight title for the first time.
But a good argument could be made. As many times as you roll the dice, 3-4 times it might not go in your favor. That 4th, 5th time, exactly what you need. The last time he challenged, besides the Halloween Lockdown match, he was screwed out of that match by Jay Fatal. Clear as day.
And rocking Terry Funk. Look at this man.
In his first appearance since signing for FMW, Joseph Robinson makes his way to the ring, kneeling before the Tokyo Dome crowd.
The smile on Joseph Robinson's face. World Heavyweight Champion. Rockin' Terry Funk OG Japan outfit. This is funking amazing.
Almost got me twice now, Lee. Happy to be where he calls home. Robinson made very little debate as to what he wanted this match to be tonight against Mike Storm. He took it right to his roots.
Well, it looks like Tokyo is ready. Jeff, are you ready?
I was ready last week, Lee.
Well, then I think I'm going to hand it over to the guys in the ring. From Newcastle upon Tyne, England, weighing in at 215 pounds, indestructible Mike Storm.
Introducing the champion from Detroit, Michigan, weighing in at 266 pounds. He is the world's heavyweight champion, the machine, Joseph Robinson.
As Robinson said earlier, the only thing that separates this match from an unsanctioned match is the fact that it is for a title. And therefore, it has to officially happen.
That FMW World title that has been around since the debut of Fat Money Wrestling. Held high, center of the ring. The title that so many legendary EFET wrestlers have held is now on the line. Mike Storm, Joseph Robinson going at it.
Missed with the clothesline. Snapmare by Bike Storm. Looking to pick Robinson up. After the first few times he's been hit by that, Robinson knows exactly how to get out of it. Dodged the Mike Storm crossbody right into a lumbar check. Quick to mock Mike Storm. That's one of Mike's patented maneuvers, as you know, Lee.
Definitely is. I can see it as soon as it happened that this match is going to be one of the matches where you need to pay attention to every detail.
Big belly-to-belly suplex of his own. And in the corner, wrenches scratching right at the forehead, right at the eyes of Storm. There is no love lost between these two.
And flipping off the camera.
Storm playing to the crowd as Robinson pulls out a ladder.
Oh!
As is typically the rule, you set up the tool, it will be used against you. But Robinson quick to change the momentum in his favor with a right hand. And a knee right to the forehead of Mike Storm takes him off of his feet.
I am absolutely in love with this Terry Funk tribute outfit Joseph Robinson is rocking tonight here in the Tokyo Dome. And I know all these guys here in Japan and women here in the arena are loving it just as much as I am. Oh!
Oh my lord, a poison rana. Drop kick to the base of the neck of Robinson. And Storm showing a very cerebral style tonight, as evidenced by the apron leg drop. Big chops to the chest of Storm again with the knee. Storm able to roll out of the ring. It's caught with another chop from Robinson. Robinson follows up with an elbow to the heart. Jawbreaker for Robinson. Just as soon as Storm tries to get the momentum going in his favor, Robinson breaks it up with big rights to the ribs.
Now I know.
A clubbing blow to the back.
I know you've called a Tokyo Street fight before, Jeff. Have you ever called? I don't think you've ever called a death brawl.
No, I have not.
This is going to be some fun because this is not the main event, folks. So I know this seems like the main event because this match is already something that you can't take your eyes away from. But we still have one more segment match brawl after this.
Blood pouring from the head of Mike Storm after that big boot from Robinson. As you were speaking, Lee. It's Storm with Callis.
Well, you know the boss. I got this whole list of things I'm supposed to point out.
Get him a bottle of wine before the show. He'll forget about it.
Oh! Elbow drop there by Joseph Robinson. Almost called him Terry Funk.
This would be the appropriate night for it.
Ooh, straight to the brim of the nose. Mike Storm definitely was looking for some payback there with that move.
Storm beginning to gather momentum just as quick as he does. Big neck breaker. Storm getting to the ropes, trying to get back to his feet. And Robinson giving him no quarter whatsoever. Throws him onto the apron outside the ring. Oh God. This can't be. Oh, my Lord. Right off of the apron.
Man, he bounced off that apron so hard, he thought he bounced right out of FMW. I mean, absolutely incredible.
Fuck.
Oh, knee to the gut. Mike Storm into the announce table. And it looks like Joseph Robinson might very well just take Mike Storm right out.
My table, really? Jesus Christ. I got to work here, man. What the?
Oh! Oh! And you said Mike Storm was looking pretty cerebral earlier. I think Joseph just topped him and then added in a little bit of you-know-who.
A little bit of a bow there to the crowd as they chant, this is awesome, and this definitely is awesome.
Mike Storm still somehow alive, throwing Robinson into the ring.
Into a tiger bomb. Pulls him over, goes for a pin.
One, two, kick out.
Pulling at the leg, stretching the hamstring of Robinson. Storm just wasn't able to put enough into it to keep Robinson down, who fights his way free.
What is either of these men going to have to do to put down the other?
All they got to do is get a little crafty. They can use whatever the hell they want. I already used my damn table.
Oh, he hands him! Oh! Oh! A little going
verbal
away
abuse
present.
To follow.
Because Mike Storm just got sent home mentally. That had to have hurt.
Robinson starting to become known for using this. Pulls Storm over the top rope and an exploder right back inside the ring. Oh my Lord!
One, two, three, oh, oh, oh! Mike Storm almost had the world title! We wouldn't even be able to get to the main event because all Tokyo would have just been in an uproar. He went for another cover, but a kick out at two.
Robinson looking to go for the pedigree, hits it.
One, two.
These two are just trading near falls at this point in the match.
And it's hard to believe that we're only hitting the 10-minute mark. Because these guys have absolutely tried everything.
Trifecta of chair shots.
That's indestructible, Mike Storm. I don't know what you're doing with them chair shots, Joseph. Oh,
breaking down bit by bit.
Mike Storm is just barely hanging on.
Wrenching right at the arm, up to the elbow.
And then look, he just fell off there. Fell right out of the ring. Almost like
Old
he fell right off
blows.
The side of the earth. Oh! Off the ring, or the railing there.
I Big right hand from Robinson, who makes his way out towards the crowd. Storm deciding to go into the ring.
That's very Mike Storm right there.
Doesn't want to fight in the crowd, doesn't want to take a risk. Calling Robinson into the ring, Robinson goes for a chair. But Rips. Storm intercepted.
Oh. Oh, Joseph. Nope, reversal there again. It's going back and forth. Oh!
Omega Driver. Cross chop to set him up.
And another
second attempt to the pedigree.
Bow to the king. And one, two, three. Ladies and gentlemen, Joseph Robinson retains in the Tokyo Dome.
He said he was walking out with the title tonight. And his words ring true again. Yeah, it was the damn table.
Terry Funk's attire is being done right by holding a world title at the end of the night. And I just rhymed. Ladies and gentlemen, Joseph Robinson retains.
Joseph Mitch. But with that match being over, we are left with just one for the evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, you know I've been ready for this one, Jeff.
Oh, I cannot wait for this match.
Look at how honored he is to accept the world title again.
What that title means. That's not like winning the SSW world title.
And then, of course, the shout out to EOP. EOP walking away with two titles tonight? Three titles. Excuse me.
Three titles.
Three titles.
And a potential opportunity at a world title.
Well, here we go. Starting out the death brawl.
In his second match of the evening, unsuccessful in his United States Championship attempt.
But he can put all that behind him here right now, Jeff. Because if you walk out of Death Brawl this year, not only do you become the Death Brawl champion and you have to defend that title next year, but you also get a title shot. And did they change it to whatever title they choose?
That is what I'm told.
Whatever title they choose. Cameron Logan Linehunter could walk out tonight and challenge for any title he wants if he wins. And that goes for anyone else in this match.
He would definitely be my favorite for this match.
Man, I'm just excited to be here for another Death Brawl. You know they talked about canceling this.
Not gonna happen. Match like this is timeless. This match alone puts 55,000 people inside this dome every single year. We don't even have to announce a card. Why would we get rid of that?
Yes, that is definitely right. We're going on an hour and at least 20 minutes or 25. And in all that time, these guys, not a single person has left this arena except for maybe a bathroom break.
Or popcorn run.
Yeah, I mean, we do have a really good stanza. I heard they moved Sally to a nice little area up there.
Yeah, it's way better than Monster Truck Rally.
Wasn't someone supposed to bring us tacos?
Yeah, well, Brad happened.
We'll talk about him later. Hey, Verte, who was also in a brutal match tonight after being knocked. I can't believe he was even cleared to compete in the Death Brawl.
Seven stitches to the forehead. He did not suffer a concussion. I'm told by the medical examiner he was able to be cleared without much of a problem.
Well, Murte out here and ready for battle, it looks like.
But he could have just as easily been lying about any sort of pain or any sort of dizziness in order to be able to get this sort of opportunity.
I mean, he's a demon. Do they even have that?
I mean, I don't know. I try to ask the guy these kind of questions.
Silent treatment.
It's like staring into eternity. And coming out to the ring here in just a moment, we have the FMW Extreme Champion, Chris Michaels.
And Murte looks ready for it. And you know there's more people coming, Murte. Calm down. Chris Michaels.
Murte just likes to fight.
Is it happy? Look how happy this man is. He's throwing EOP logos left and right.
He's ready to get this match going. Another man that's got to be told to wait just a moment.
I mean, he won the Extreme title. This man's sitting on top of the moon. What could he add to that tonight? A death
a shot at any other title.
Victory.
And theoretically, he and Robinson could challenge for the tag team titles once again if he were to win this match.
Yes, he could. I mean, anything is possible. Winning a Death Brawl. This is the second annual Death Brawl of FMW. I hope you guys have enjoyed the pay-per-view so far. If you're just now tuning in, you should really go back and watch the rest of it. But I'm Lee Dark, my associate Jeff Beck, and making his way to the ring right now is another member of EOP, Crunk Man.
Recently drafted to Underground, Crunkman has quickly made an impact. And if he could follow up with a win tonight, he could challenge Chris Chaos for the Global Championship if he so chose.
See, the question I have, Jeff, and you've been hanging out with the guys like, you know, traveling. What is the, have they talked about what they're going to do here? Is Crunkman and Chris have plans to work together? Did they just make like a truce and just said, you know, it is what it is while we're in this Death Brawl? Like, what's the plan?
We're here to fight. Nothing personal, just business.
I mean, I bet there'll be some form of tag teaming, but if not, we'll see. I mean, I don't know what to expect here. This is the first time I think any of these individuals besides King Dominator have been in a Death Brawl.
And KD definitely going to attempt to make use of that experience. And after successfully retaining the FMW Tag Team Championships tonight with JMR, Christian Gunn makes his way to the ring.
Christian Gunn is a special individual. He's done it all in FMW and other promotions, but I think we've all seen him at the top, tag teaming with JMR, Team Radicals.
Some guys are just better tag team wrestlers than they are in the singles division, and there's nothing wrong with it. Think of the great tag teams that we've had throughout the years. Ray Stevens and Pat Patterson. Ray Stevens and Nick Bockwinkel. Art Anderson and Tully Blanchard.
And you got the dark horse Christian Gunn and the Maverick JMR.
And obviously pleased with himself, he takes a long look out at the crowd.
Christian Gunn, I think, still feeling the effects from that tag team match as he's taking his time to get into the ring here.
I think the first time when they made their way to the ring, they didn't take much time to look out at the crowd. This is a big arena. Some of the greatest.
He is your former Death Brawl champion, well, current Death Brawl champion, King Dominic.
A lot of first time guys booked to this arena realize that as soon as they get here, this place is huge. If you go into the lobby, you can see photos from some of the biggest events that have taken place, some of the most memorable of the events, and some of the greatest moments in wrestling history have happened in this very arena.
The first ever FW Death Brawl, Triple C and Venom beat each other all over this arena.
And though he's been in a bit of a slump lately, AD walks into this match very confident, knowing he's one of the few men in this match with any experience in this kind of match.
He used to wear an armband on his arm that had the Death Brawl logo, but I'm pretty sure they made him take it off, because tonight he could walk out no longer Death Brawl champion.
But if you ask him in person, he will tell you there is no chance of that happening.
The man that calls himself the gold standard, King Dominator, the king of perfection.
And you could expect this man to target Chris Michaels all throughout the match.
I didn't pick anyone yet, and I do now. Picked off Johnny Gage. That's my vote.
We may have a game changer in terms of your picks coming up just after this entrant here.
Oh,
save your picks.
Is there a mystery?
He's not a mystery, but you may have overlooked who all is in this match. Just a few weeks ago, he put his spot in this match on the line and brawled with Joseph Robinson to a double countout after attempting a pre-match run-in.
Oh!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the truth. God made me in his image. Who the fuck made you? You want my voice from me, you can have it. Just know, I sound like this because
everyone's
the
fun.
Devil has my throat. I make your inside shift. That is my gift. The sea part.
Everyone just may be fucked indeed.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't know who this man is, let me go ahead and lay it all out for you. He is Lucien Gage. We call him Sinister. He is a former Patrimonio champion, former global heavyweight champion, former tag team champion, former USA champion, former pro fighting champion, former Royal or Battle Royal or Our version of the Royal Rumble winner, ladies and gentlemen, Sinister.
And what that means, layman terms, is you have no chance of walking out of this the same man that you walked into it.
Cause the blowing wind hurts. You want your childhood taken from you.
Normally I would have an idea of the title that the winner would go after, but in dealing with Lucien Gage, there's absolutely no clue.
Well, here we go.
Going after the biggest man in the ring, Sinister goes right for Johnny Gage.
Now remember, a lot of these guys have been in matches already tonight.
A record 5 out of the 8 individuals. Only Sinister, Crunkman, and KD haven't been in matches tonight.
Which automatically gives these 3 the upper hand.
On paper.
Hangman.
Just as predicted.
Yep. I was just about to comment on that myself, Jeff.
Muerte with a snap arm breaker on Muerte.
So let me go ahead and lay this all out for you guys real quick. We're not going to be able to get all the action, but I will go ahead and say who's in pairs right this moment. Crunkman and Muerte. Cameron Logan Lionhunter just knocked Christian Gunn out of the ring. Sinister is throwing around KD, and on the outside is Michaels and Hanged Man.
Michaels just blocked a fisherman suplex attempt and talking shit to Hangman. You would need 4 TVs to call all this action.
Oh, there's no way. Michaels and Hangman are still going at it. Cameron Logan Lionhunter is attacking Crunkman in the ring. Sinister is going to round it. Whoever wants it gets it. I mean, now it's Christian Gunn.
And I worry for Christian Gunn here. For reasons like that.
No!
He's lucky he didn't get thrown outside the ring. Sinister would do it.
Sinister is going on a body slamming rampage.
Whipping the back of KD's head right into the mat.
Hangman and Michaels have not stopped. Ooh, Sinister though to the outside.
That's a hatred that never dies.
Oh, KD! Step up Enziguri to Crunkman. Crunkman rolls to the outside. King Dominator now has Christian Gunn. Christian got knocked down. Murte in a choke hold, sleeper hold by Cameron. Fell back. This could be it for Murte. This could be it for Murte.
He's got it cinched in deep.
No, broken up. The demon escapes. One, two, three. And Michaels again pins Hangman Johnny Gage. Twice in a night. Wouldn't that ignite a fire inside of you so bright?
As I said, that is a hatred that will never end.
Michaels is now fighting Sinister, and I mean, not to be mean to your friend Michaels. Oh, Murte eliminated by Cameron Logan Lionhunter. But I don't know if Michaels can pull off Sinister by himself. It looks like he might not have to. Cameron Logan Lionhunter. Oh, take that back. Was going to say they were going to work together there maybe to eliminate Sinister, but. Oh, sweet chin music on the outside. Christian Gunn is sleeping right now.
Back on the inside, Sinister talking to the crowd before targeting Cameron once more. Big clothesline.
Crunkman turned the page of Christian Gunn, and one, two, and three, he's eliminated.
Big suplex to Michaels from Sinister. And Crunkman giving the love to everybody, takes King Dominator off his feet.
Look at the men left in this match. The only one out of this bunch I would say that is kind of odd he's still here is King Dominator. King Dominator, I know he won the last Death Brawl, but the man hasn't exactly been on top lately. This is crazy that he's still in the ring with all these guys right now. Oh!
Spin out Michinoku driver from King Dominator onto Sinister.
Oh, purge DDT by the one and only Sinister. One, two. Oh.
I think he may have just let him up.
Yeah, I don't know what just happened there. And Sinister is one that just, he'll do what he wants.
He likes to torture you. He may have just left him to have a little bit more fun with later.
It's like a cat and mouse.
He knows he's got this match won in his eyes. All he's got to do is toy around until he feels like going for the kill.
Sinister goes right out. Oh, Michaels, though, dodges it. Oh, Sinister went to go chop the chest. Oh, look at that by Michaels!
Another front flip Hurricane Rana, quick to go for the pin. Knows he doesn't have too many chances against
one.
Sinister.
I mean, the referee took forever to get in there. That may have been a three. We'll never know. Oh, but Crunkman from behind takes out. Crunkman from behind took out Chris Michaels.
Nothing personal, just business. And in a rare show of strength, King Dominator was able to fend off Sinister for a moment before taking out Crunkman.
I think Sinister backed up to let Crunkman fly through. I think that was all a ploy. One, two, kick out by Sinister. And Chris Michaels right into the ring, right? Oh, did you see that? Ooh, Crunkman's arm got wrapped up in the ropes and kind of bent back. He's rolled to the outside now. I hope he's okay.
And in the middle of calling that, Michaels was hit with a big Ushiguroshi.
Oh! 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 Purge DDT on Sinister! Chris Michaels hit it! One! Two! And somehow Sinister kicked out.
If there's anybody that knows how to manage that move, it'd be Sinister.
A belly to
caught the leg of Crunkman.
Reversal there, and Cameron Logan Lionhunter is going after Chris Michaels. KD is still on the outside, baby in his head. Croakman seems to be okay. I don't really see him babying that arm.
Posed a wrench on the jaw and on the neck of Sinister. JD's back in the ring. And Cameron Michaels trapped.
Yeah. Oh, Sinister. Sinister broke it up. What is going it's through the head way. Of Sinister?
Big suplex right to Cameron.
Sinister is just picking who he wants to stay in this match.
Who he wants to eliminate. He doesn't want to give anybody a win. Even if that win's just a small victory in the overall war.
He saved Chris Michaels from elimination. He decided KD may deserve to go, but he let him go and now he went back in after Cameron. Sinister's just playing. Oh, a Cameron cutter! Lion cutter! Here we go!
And Michaels has opened up for the second time tonight.
Oh! Sinister broke it up again!
And this has only served to infuriate Cameron. Big body slam. Cameron rolling outside the ring.
Ooh, he missed. And he hit Croakman. And now he's looking at Michaels.
Back body drop. KD showing the athleticism.
Oh, and then he stops and goes after him. Purge DDT!
Now he wants to go for the kill shot.
One,
it looks.
Two, three. Well, KD is not going to be a two-time Death Brawl champion.
Croakman missed on the clothesline there.
Sinister could have went after Michaels, chose not to, roll to the outside. He's making
body
EOP
drop
fight.
Into a slam.
He's making EOP fight. That is Sinister's move right there. He knows that eventually, you know, friends can fight, but you fight too much.
You can draw some bad blood.
And Michaels
and
eliminates.
And that might be the seed.
Croakman right there.
Slips in a cross face on Cameron.
Cameron broke out of it.
Cameron went to clothesline Sinister there, caught Michaels.
And a purge DDT by Michaels.
Waits for Michaels to get up.
He's trying so hard. Oh, he's got him.
Catches him with an arm trap suplex. Turns around to Cameron, but Cameron catches him with a big left hand, the southpaw.
Cameron was playing possum there, standing up dazed.
Clothesline for his troubles.
Cameron back to his feet. Oh, on the concrete.
There's no mat there, there is only carpet.
Oh! Oh, he made it on the pad, thankfully.
But that doesn't help hardly
at
all.
Oh, but Michaels did not get the same respect.
Back body drop right back onto the concrete for Michaels.
Oh! And this could be it. He just read Michaels' rights to the concrete. Where's this darn ref at? Sinister got tired of waiting.
Forever.
Oh! And a Sinister bottom took out Cameron Logan Lionhunter. Oh! Michaels just barely snuck that kick in.
Went for Grizzly Magnum, got caught with a big kick.
Here we go.
One, back in the ring.
Oh!
Only for just a moment.
These three men, any one of these guys could win. But Sinister, he still looks 100%.
He's definitely got the best chance on paper. He's the only one out of the three that hasn't been in a match. And he's the only man standing right now after that chair shot.
That is no lie. Oh, and onto the ground. He just read him his rights again. And ended his time in the death brawl.
He is not walking out completely unhappy, though. He does have that extreme title to take back home with him.
Unbelievable job by Chris Michaels, staying in as long as he did, definitely. But now it's down to two men, and oh! What a flatliner.
And Sinister's proud of himself. He saved Michaels for himself. And now he's got Cameron all to himself.
He played this whole game from start to finish, cat and mouse.
Almost had a belly-to-belly suplex, but Cameron was wise to it, broke free.
Headbutt. Oh, backbreaker.
Little bit of technical difficulty there.
We're
the cameras weren't able
that,
to catch everything for a moment.
Two, three, Sinister! Ladies and gentlemen, all you missed was he went for the cutter, Sinister spun out, and then he turned around, and then you guys were back, and he had him exactly where he wanted him. But ladies and gentlemen, that's all we have for you tonight. I'm Lee Dark.
I'm Jeff Beck, and congratulations to Sinister on the Death Brawl win tonight.